after a 2-0 victory here at AFC Wimbledon. It's Luton manager Nathan Jones on iFollow. A victory, a clean sheet away from home. Not as good a performance perhaps as some of the home games recently, but overall you got the job done.
I think it was as good, it's just not as fluent, you know. You know, it's a different type of game. They come and match this absolute man for man all over us, and that means, you know, there wasn't space to exploit and so on. But we showed a thoroughly professional side today. Clean sheet, defended our box fantastically well against difficult opponents because they're in a false position because they shouldn't be where they are because we've watched them and they've got some, you know, some decent players. Hansen's a real threat, but I thought he was marshalled fantastically well by our centre halves and Glenn Ray in front of him. So, you know, we had to really dig in today and show a different side of our character and the performance level. And I'm very, very pleased with that. You know, first half we weren't really at it, but second half I thought much, much better. And I said the margin should have been far greater.
I mean, you summed up the first half there. There were very limited few chances, although we could have had an early goal. Danny's header coming back off the post and then another cleared off the line a bit later.
Yeah, but look, the trouble when you go man for man with everyone, it takes time to grind that down, you know. We had to do it at Wickham and we've had to do it at Charlton and things like that when people go. So sometimes it takes time just to grind things out and to wait till the space opens up, and then we got to exploit the space. Now we did that, and yeah, probably the best chance of the game Danny headed against the post. But it was a bit of a war of attrition first half, and we knew that we just, you know, make sure we'd stay in the game. We should, when the game opens up, and then when it does, then we showed the quality. We asked them to be a bit braver at half time, and they were. They came out, we passed it much better second half, and as I said, we scored two, should have scored three with the penalty, and also keeper made a couple of good saves to keep the score down a little bit. So look, we're pleased. And away performance, clean sheet, 3 points, that's all that matters.
I mean, the second halves do generally seem to be the better half and the better performances if the first half struggled a little bit, and it showed again this afternoon, and that was critical, wasn't it?
Well, you tend to find that the first halves are tighter, you know, but then when the space opens up, then you have to exploit that space and be clinical and show your quality, and we did that, you know. It's a tight ground here, and you know, it's a difficult one. I mean, it's not a Barnsley ground and things like that, and it does. The aesthetics matter when you're playing. But I thought we were excellent. It's a away performance. I asked them for away performance. This is the one that maybe last year and the year before we might have drawn, we might have lost, you know, we might have let ourselves down with that last game of the month. You know, we mentioned it a few times last year, last game of the month, but we didn't. And we showed a real professional edge to us and a clinical edge because, as I said, two good goals. And if I'm honest, you know, that being disrespectful, it should have been more.
Let's have a look at the goals then. A nice little team move to begin with. Andrew Shinney then put a delightful cross in for Pelle Radokampani, his first goal of the season.
Yeah, and said we asked them to be braver, as I said, and they were. They passed it better. We got Shinney got in, and then he picked out a great ball. And just said he's in a real good position, Pelle in the box, and shows a bit of composure, you know, because sometimes he's hit and miss, and that could have ended up in in Kingston and things. But he showed a clinical edge, and then I thought Elliot Lee, you know, Elliot has come back in after being a few weeks out, and then showed that little bit of quality when we really needed it. Because I said it was a tight game, it wasn't a game for Elliot really, but it was a real tight game, and he showed his quality because he had one or two pot shots. But you know, I'm delighted that that he's good.
Lovely strike to settle the tie. It should have been settled earlier though, shouldn't it, from the penalty spot? Yeah. I know you've probably not seen it because you turn your back when the penalties are taken, but are you aware of what's happened?
I know what's happened, and it wasn't a day for chip penalties. You know, this is what we're saying. I just spoken to him, Gordon, but it's just like, it's not a day for chip penalties today. Today's a day that you wrap it in the corner and we get out of here, you know, with 3 points. Because it's a difficult place to come, a real tough place to come. And that's what it was today. It wasn't a chip penalty kind of day. And I know he's in good form and so on. And that's a disappointing thing, really, because it keeps you on a knife edge then. Mm-hmm. And lucky, you know, my centre-half, if I'd have done that, I'd be in some teams that I'd be pinned against a wall now, you know, because they'd be thinking, hang on, it ain't good enough. It's not about you. And he's just let himself down a tiny bit, but he's done it before and scored, and he doesn't miss, and he's a big, big player for us. But I just wanted him to show a little bit more of a clinical edge today, and professional edge, really.
And Elliot, we've mentioned there, has got him out of jail a little bit with the deciding to control the game. A great finish from Elliot, back in the side because George Grant's missed out today through injury.
Yeah, look, he's picked up a little bit of soreness and stiffness, and so we didn't want to risk him. And we've had three games in a week, and the way we play and the efforts they put in, at times you want to mix it up, but when you've had two fantastic home performances, you don't want to change something really. But the fact that we were forced to do that, then look, come back and pay dividends because Elliot has scored. So look, we've used the squad and that's what the squad's there for. And hopefully now we can, you know, start to get a few more back because I said Potts and because another week and so does Barry and also George as well.
And important after the home victories to start picking up the points on the road. We've got two consecutive away games. That's 3 points in the bag after the first one.
Yeah, good. And I said, it finishes the month off well. We've had a fantastic month, you know, 7 games, 6 victories and one defeat at Barnsley. So, look, wonderful a month for us. I would have taken that all day long, you know, without being disrespectful. It's been a real tough month against some real good sides and against tricky away games. But we're delighted with that return. And as I said, it's another tough month coming up. You know, a few away games, starting the month with an away game. But look, we're in decent form and we've got a week to try and dust them down and to get everyone ready and so on. And then we'll be looking forward to it.
Lovely. Thanks very much. Cheers.
You asked to be braver after half time.
Of course, and he's a brave player anyway, that's why he's in the side. I mean, he's not in the side because of his towering head, so he won 7 or 8 towering headers. But, you know, he shows that bravery, but that's why we brought Trini to the club, because the game's like this, and he did it here, you know. And one thing I forgot to mention, this was a big game for me, to be honest with you, because I've had my worst defeat here as a manager. When we lost 4-1 here, and I couldn't understand how we did, because large parts of the game we controlled it. It's just we got shocked by the physicality of Wimbledon. Today we matched that all day, and as I said, we came here and we're brave, and we're a lot braver second half, a lot more like us. And I said, the times are tight because we're diamond for diamond, so you have to win the war, if you like, and we did that. And as I said, our quality showed, and I'm very, very pleased.
Was it the back line as well? Because I mean, they had balls in the box, but nothing really at James's goal, did they?
No, nothing really. But that's because we put our head on. I mean, everyone won headers in things. The two centre halves did. Glenn Ray was immense again, and JJ won a great header on the back stick. Sheehan came on and won a header. So they all contributed, because we knew we'd have to do it. Because when you got, you know, someone like James Hansen playing up front, you know that if they want to use him, then they're going to put balls in the box, and he's a real, real threat. He's been a threat throughout his career. Sheffield United, Bradford, you know, a real, real tough player to play, and I thought we marshalled him fantastically well. Look, any win would have been good, but I'm pleased with that, because clean sheet, away win, a couple of goals, should have been more, but look, 3 points.